Hi, my name is Graham. This is my first Ignite talk. I'm really excited today to talk about something I'm extremely passionate about. I'm passionate about K-5 mathematics, in particular about basic fact understanding. And what I want to do today is share with you that there is a difference. There really is a difference when students learn their facts from memorization and from memory. Although the two may appear to be extremely similar and actually the same, there's so much more happening when students learn their facts from memory and memorization, and I want to explain how. When students learn their facts through memorization, this is what happened when we were all students. We'd go home with our flashcards, we'd memorize our flashcards. Me, myself, I was not able to memorize my flashcards, so when my mom and dad gave me a test at home to prepare me for the next day, this was the end result. It left my parents and myself feeling inadequate that I wasn't good at mathematics because I could not memorize my facts. And what was sad was the very next day, when I went to school and I sat down at the desk to go ahead and complete my time test, I did even worse. I was only able to answer two questions in a minute. So what I've come to learn in my years of being an educator is just because I wasn't fast at mathematics did not mean that I was fluent. And that is what I'm trying to push today and trying to suggest today. So where does the definition of fluency come? Well, the definition of fluency might come from English language arts. When I was a third grade teacher, I'd have students that could read 120 words in a minute and not tell me a single word of what they just read. I'd have students that could read 80 words and tell me everything of what they just read. That's true comprehension. There's lots of people that have devoted their time and endless years to this understanding of fact fluency that can be built from memory. They're trying to get this message out to the general public. The same thing as NCTM. NCTM has been trying to share this message for years and years, that memorization is not the best way to learn their facts. Memorization does not build fluency. Fluency is when a student is able to be efficient, is able to be accurate, and able to be flexible. Look at this example right here. A student subtracting 13 minus 7. Well, what they do is you can see this conversation going on, and they say, if I have 3, I can't take away 7, so they go next door and they borrow 1. This right here is a perfect example of the negative effects of memorization and that procedural thinking. What I'm here today to suggest is that memorization has nothing to do with strategy. What I am suggesting is that when a student learns their facts from memory, it has everything to do with strategy. Strategy is the underpinnings of how we need our students to learn their facts. But it all comes back to automaticity. So automaticity of a strategy can appear to be memorization, but it's not. A student has used that strategy repeatedly, over and over and over, to the point where it becomes automatic, to where it might actually look like memorization. So here, automaticity, you can see the definition, but it usually is a result of a learning. When students are learning their facts, they're not memorizing. When they're memorizing, that's all they're doing. But when a student is learning their facts from memory, they're embedding those strategies that they'll be able to take on later in life and be successful. What I've come to find out is that many of the students that I've taught previously, and even myself included, are not able to memorize their facts. But what I have learned is that all through the use of strategies, all students can learn their facts. I ask this question: why do we still have students that are in high school and middle school still using their fingers to add and subtract? This has been an issue way before the quote-unquote new math or before Common Core. So why do we still want to go down that exact same path? What I want to suggest is that just a student's ability to memorize facts is going to tell me nothing as their teacher as to how mathematically competent they are in and outside of the classroom. It only tells me that they're able to memorize their facts. Here's a great example. The penguin on the left has learned his facts from memory, has learned his facts through memorization. If he forgets what 6 times 7 is, he has to go back to skip counting. 6, 12, 18. The penguin on the right, if he forgets his facts, 6 times 7, he can say 6 times 6 is 36 plus 6 more is 42. The students who have used memorization, well, that's all they have. All they have to fall back on is memorization. But a student who has learned their facts from memory, well, they have automaticity. Well, they have flexibility. And all of these are the underpinnings because their facts were built through strategy. Flexible thinking, this from memory, this strategic thinking, can be applied to all areas of mathematics. Memorization can't. So as you can see right here, when our students are learning their facts from memory, although it might appear to be memorization, there's so much more happening underneath that. So what we need to do is we need to question our students. We need to expose our students to opportunities to learn and invent their own strategies because there's so much more happening. And if we only rely on memorization for their students to learn facts, well, we all know what the outcome would be.